My name is Darrell Barlett, and I'm the CEO of kSA Associates. And kSA is a company that makes metrology tools mainly for the semiconductor and thin film deposition industries. And we just developed a new tool called the kSA Emissometer that we're very excited about. And this tool is designed to characterize in detail MOCVD carriers. And the goal of that is to increase yield for device manufacturing. So we're going to open up the lid on the tool and slide out the holder for the carriers. And today we're just going to work with K465i MOCVD carriers. This tool will also handle EPIC 700 MOCVD carriers and really any carrier just by modifying this spindle. So I'm going to pick one 465i carrier. This one is for 4-inch wafers. And we're going to load it up on the tool. And the nice thing about this tool is we've got a couple laser indicators. So we've got one laser indicator right at the center so you can know where to place the tool. And then you'll see a second laser indicator at the back. So if you have a dimple or an alignment mark on the carrier, you can align the laser to that mark. And then push the holder back until it won't go any further. And then there's a nice lock here. Lock the holder into place. And now we're ready to spin up the tool. So now we push the platter rotation button and the tool will slowly spin up to speed. And this tool is set to spin at about 110 RPM. So let's go over a little bit of the technology behind this tool. So the principal operation of this tool is we bring in typically 940 nanometer light from an LED on this input lens cell. And that 940 nanometer light then reflects and scatters off of the carrier. And we look at both the specular reflection at a 45 degree angle, and that's what this detector detects. And then we also look at the diffuse light that is scattered at normal and close to normal incidence, and that's what the center lens cell detects. And then at the same time, we constantly reference the input signal with a third detector in the back that is split off here, so that if the intensity of the incoming light varies at all, we take that into account, we take a reference continuously, and we basically normalize the system. And what that always gives us then at every single position on the measurement is it gives us the true absolute reflectance, both the diffuse reflectance and the specular reflectance. And that's key. First of all, a lot of people want to know what the absolute reflectance is on their carrier. Secondly, it's that absolute total reflectance, both the diffuse and the specular, that we use to calculate the emissivity of the carrier. And that's really the most important measurement that this tool makes, is the total emissivity at every single position on this carrier, because the emissivity then directly tells you how much heat is radiated from this carrier and therefore what kind of temperature uniformity you will get across the carrier and what kind of temperature uniformity finally you will see across your wafers. And that's what is of utmost importance. So we want to look at that total emissivity and characterize the MOCVD carrier so that the customer and the user knows, is this okay to use for the next growth run? So obviously this is on a linear stage and it's going to scan through the entire carrier radius. So we start at radius zero and then the user can input the resolution of the radial scan. So we move to a radius and we take all the azimuthal or angular data, move to the next radius, and so forth. And we use a very fast data acquisition board so that we can acquire all three signals, the reference signal, the diffuse reflectance signal, and the specular reflectance signal simultaneously as we acquire. The total time for a K465i carrier, if you put in a resolution of a radial resolution of 1 millimeter, so we go in 1 millimeter steps radially, that total time is about 10 minutes. If you go to an EPIC 700 carrier, which is now a 700 or 695 millimeter diameter, obviously it's going to take longer. It takes about 20 minutes to do a full scan on an EPIC 700 carrier. In terms of the sample detection size, at every position. I can show you that by attaching a 660 nanometer LED, which I just did, and show you the typical spot size. So if I turn on the 660 nanometer LED, you can see that red spot there. Again, it's coming in at a 45-degree angle, so it's oblong, slightly oblong. But that spot diameter is around 2 millimeters. So we're sampling at every position about a 2 millimeter spot size as we scan across this carrier. And that's ultimately approximately our resolution, although we can actually set the scanning to be higher resolution than that. But normally, we will run this with the 940 nanometer LED because the 940 nanometer LED, first of all, matches the wavelength that a lot of people look at the temperature of the carrier inside the reactor with a pyrometer. And also, the 940 nanometer LED actually gives us a little better diffuse scattering resolution.